नमस्कार एंड वेलकम टू दिस एपिसोड ऑफ राग परिचय. वी कंटिन्यू विद द कल्याण फैमिली एंड आफ्टर यमन लास्ट वीक वी मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट मेंबर ऑफ द फैमिली यमन कल्याण. यू नो यमन एंड इट्स टू वेरी क्लोज वैरायंट्स, द कल्याण एंड द यमन कल्याण. दीज थ्री ऑलमोस्ट गो टुगेदर, you know, because of the very, very small differences in them. And for this reason, you know, they have been used probably the most by the Hindi film songs. All the songs which I played in the beginning, they were all based on some version of Yaman, either the Kalyan or the Yaman Kalyan. So Yaman is the purest form of Yaman, and Kalyan is obtained by making some variation in that, and Yaman Kalyan is further obtained by adding another note to that. So let us go on to see how this happens. So Yaman, as we saw, is Niregama Dhanisa. So it omits the Shadja and the Pancham completely in the Aroha. And we saw that the per a sangati is what defines the Yaman, and of course the entire Kalyan family too. Kalyan takes a bit of a liberty from this chalan, and it allows the use of sarega instead of nirega. Or in addition to Nirega, it also allows Sarega, and similarly it also allows the Pa Dhani. So which means the Sa and the Pa, which were completely not allowed in Yaman in the Aroha, can be taken in the Aroha in Kalyan. Kalyan by itself is sung quite rarely in the classical performance. So if you see, what is going to happen there is, in addition to this phrase, you could also get, so sare ga goes in Kalyan. What Yaman Kalyan does is, in addition to this bit of flexibility added to Yaman, it also adds the Shuddha Madhyam to it. So now you are using both the Madhyams. In my opinion, the addition of this Shuddha Madhyam, you know, it adds a bit of romantic feel to the rag. And because of this addition of Shuddha Madhyam, a bit of pairing changes. Because if you remember in Yaman, it was the Nishad Gandhar and Nishad Tivra Madhyam. Nishad Tivra Madhyam was a good pair there, the Sapa pair, and the Tivra Madhyam and Nishad. Now, the Tivra Madhyam is going to be augmented with the Shuddha Madhyam also. And so the Tivra Nishad, the Shuddha Nishad, becomes a bit feeble. And you would find a lot of gama dha sa just touching the nishad. That is what happens in Yaman Kalyan. And of course the Shuddha Madhyam is more taken in the Avroha. So let's see how this happens. This part is of course the Yaman part. This is where the Shuddha Madhyam gets added.
Oh.
part is again back to Yaman. Then, while going to the Sharjah, so the Kalyan part, of course, the Pancham Rishabh Sangati, the Pare Sangati remains. You know, just to show the addition of Tivra Madhyama, I was not using it so much. But the Pancham Rishabh Sangati of the Yaman remains as it is. In practice, what has happened is Yaman Kalyan is sung a lot and performed a lot in classical performances. You know, the addition of Shuddha Madhyam gives it a beautiful shade. But the most prevalent manner in which this is done today is, you know, just add the Shuddha Madhyam in the normal Yaman performance. So for all practical purposes, Yaman Kalyan is known as that version of Yaman which has Shuddha Madhyam added to it. And of course, the Kalyan element is not so evident in the current performances. Let's go on to listen to one bandish in Yaman Kalyan, a beautiful bandish in Ek Taal. Thank you. that was Yaman Kalyan. Next week we move on to Rag Shuddha Kalyan.